hello again. We are going to take out our health. So take out your health books, and I want to try to quickly go through comprehension checks on pages 57 and what was it? Or no. Yes, 57 and 60. Sorry. Little there. Okay, so page 57. The longer you store fruits and vegetables, the more blank they lose. Yes, the more vitamins they lose. Very good. For proper food storage, the blank should be kept between 35 degrees Fahrenheit and 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Obviously, yes, the refrigerator. Why should you wash fresh fruits and vegetables before you eat them? Right, you not just germs, but also chemicals that they may use to spray on them to keep the bugs away and things. So to wash away germs and chemicals that could be on them. Why is it important to store and prepare foods properly? Because you don't want the food to spoil. You could say to keep the germs, you know, away. You could say to prevent sickness or food poisoning. Any one of those, okay? Anything like that is what we're looking for, all right? So did you get those? Hopefully got all those well. Good. Now page 60. List two ways sickness can be spread. That was an easy one too, right? Because we definitely know coughing, sneezing, that's why we're wearing face masks and stuff now, because of the disease germs that could be spread. Most germs, so coughing, sneezing, touching, kissing, all of that. Most germs enter your body through your what? Mouth or nose or what else? Remember, breaks in your skin. So when you have an opening in your skin from a cut or a scratch, you need to make sure to wash that out carefully because germs do enter your body through breaks in your skin as well. When washing your hands, we all know this now, especially we scrub for 20 seconds. We can sing the happy birthday song a couple times through. We can sing Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Those are some examples. Always blank your mouth when you cough or sneeze, and you know that one. Cover your mouth when you cough or sneeze. Good. So those are simple things that you're going to be remembering, hopefully very easily. Some of those are super easy, especially with what we're going through right now in this crazy time. So just keep those in mind. So today we're going to talk about seeking health care and what we can do when we go to the doctor. They give us sometimes medication to help us. They give us things. We talked about some things yesterday, what you can do for a headache, that, you know, just get in a dark room, put a cold compress, you know, massage the area. When you have a fever, take medication. When it gets, you know, over 102, go to the doctor. We've talked about some of those different things. So go back through and remember some of those. If you have an earache or a stuffy nose or a sore throat, you know, some of the things that you can do to take care of those and make sure that you are being aware. But we're going to talk today about some other things that we can do for minor sicknesses that we can kind of help ourselves with. So first thing, terms to remember, the first word is diagnose. Diagnose means to identify a type of illness. So when you go to the doctor diagnoses you. They figure out what might be wrong. Then viruses and bacteria, they are germs that cause illness. If your symptoms are severe or your illness lasts for several days, your parents may take you to see a doctor. He will diagnose and treat your illness. He may start by determining if your illness is caused by a virus or a bacteria, because it could be either one of those. So some of our sicknesses come from viruses, some of them come from bacteria, and your doctor has to determine which one that is. While both a virus and bacteria are germs that can cause sickness, the doctor will treat them differently. When you have a virus, your body will usually work hard to cure itself. So I just wanted to show you some pictures of viruses. They're kind of cool when you look at that to see these are actual, like, you know, blown up what do you call it, microscopic pictures of different viruses and what those different viruses might look like close up, which is kind of a neat thing. And you look at how many different, colors and shades and, all of that, that there are for these viruses. So viruses, these are many times they will, your body just works hard to cure itself. Didn't God give us amazing bodies? Your doctor may prescribe some mild medication to help you feel better while your body works to heal. Sickness can also be caused by bacteria. And so that is something else that I wanted to show, because we also have some pictures of bacteria. And when there's bacteria, look at that. Isn't that crazy? The different, I don't know if it changes anymore, ways that are, that certain bacteria might look. Okay. So there's bacterias, there's viruses. Now, when there's bacteria, in addition to mild medication to help you feel better, your doctor may prescribe an antibiotic to destroy certain kinds of harmful bacteria. If your doctor gives you medication, it is important that you take only the amount that he tells you to, at the time he tells you to take it, and for as long as he tells you to take it. So all of that is very important. If he prescribes something for that bacteria, the only way it's going to go away is if you take the amount that he tells you at the time that he tells you to take it. If it's supposed to be in the morning or morning and in the afternoon, or it's supposed to be, you do it for the time, you do it the right amount, and as long as it takes. You can't say, oh, I feel better, so I'm not going to stop taking it. No, you keep taking it until the medicine is done, until he tells you it can stop. You can stop. You should never take medications from friends or people you do not know. Remember, we kept saying yesterday, a trusted adult. Even if you and a sibling or a friend have the same sickness, take only the medication that is especially for you. Your doctor has, had many different things, like that's why they weigh you, that's why they check your personal needs and things, so that they know how much to prescribe for you. It's not going to be the same for a sibling or a friend. Should you see the doctor only when you are sick? Seeing your doctor for regular health checkups can help track your growth and prevent illness. At your checkup, your doctor will measure you and record that you are growing properly. She will check your ears and throat and listen to your heart. At these checkups, your parents may wish to have you vaccinated. A vaccination may prevent you from getting certain childhood diseases. God cares about your physical body. He knows when you do not feel well and when you have plenty of energy to run and play. When you are sick, He can help you to feel better. His word says that he even knows how many hairs are on your head. That's how much he cares about you and know. He knows. And then when you slept last night and some of those hairs came out, he knows, oh, she lost 18 hairs. And so now she only has 5,698,418 less. Okay. He knows that. How crazy is that? He can help you to feel better. His word, when you're sick, his word says that he even knows how many hairs are on your head. Okay, we just said that. He cares about your body, your soul, and your spirit. And that's such an important thing to remember and recognize. He knows about all of this, and he's going to take care of you. So why should you also visit a doctor when you're well? Because they'll track your growth. They'll track your how well you're growing, and to help prevent any other illnesses. So think about it at the bottom of the page. Do you remember how sicknesses can be prevented? List ways to help prevent getting viruses or harmful bacteria. So list those there. And we should have those down pretty well, because like I said, we've been talking about that for quite a while now. So here's common illness and what you can do to take care of that. The common cold. The symptoms would be stuffy or runny nose, sneezing, coughing, and sore throat lasts 1 to 2 weeks, okay? So those are just common things. Influenza or flu, you have a stuffy or runny nose, sneezing, fever, and a weak feeling. Tonsillitis, You have sore throat, fever, swollen neck glands, bronchitis, constant coughing, sometimes a fever. And that is very just annoying. It's kind of this constant cough. Pneumonia, it's a high fever, fast breathing, and coughing. And then chicken pox is a low fever, headache for a few days, and then the rash and the itching starts. And that lasts for 6 days after that rash. So it's those were some of the common illnesses that children have been known to get. Everyday health habits. In order to keep our bodies healthy, we must clean them regularly. This is called good personal hygiene. When you are clean, you will feel better about yourself and help keep your body from getting sick. Because germs multiply in unclean places, you also need to keep your home clean and neat. Keeping things clean will help prevent illnesses. Florence Nightingale, or illness. Florence Nightingale understood the importance of cleanliness when she began the modern nursing profession over 100 years ago. As a child, Florence enjoyed caring for babies, sick people, and wounded animals. When she was older, she spent much time studying health and devoted her life to helping and serving others. As a nurse, she taught that many sicknesses could be prevented through cleanliness and fresh air. Back when she was a nurse, people didn't realize how important it was to be clean. It wasn't a thing for them. They weren't thinking about that. But cleanliness and fresh air can help prevent sicknesses. And she taught people that. Your body. When you play outside, your body gets dirty. Perspiration, oil, and dirt that collects on your skin needs to be washed away. In order for your skin to help protect you from sickness, you need to keep your body clean. Bathing in warm water and soap washes away dirt and tiny germs. Your skin smells good because you have washed away the perspiration that can cause unpleasant odors. Regularly taking a bath or shower is an important part of personal hygiene. Be sure you adjust the water temperature before getting into the bathtub or the shower so that the hot water will not burn you. You should try to bathe in a warm room so that you do not feel too cold when you get out. Always use a clean washcloth and carefully wash every part of your skin. Be sure you rinse all the soap off your body because this will help keep your skin from drying out. If we leave any soap on our bodies, it just draws out the moisture from our skin and it dries out our skin. After your bath, dry yourself by rubbing hard with a clean towel. Now, it doesn't mean give yourself towel burn. It just means, you know, rub vigorously, give it a nice rub, because when you rub, that's massaging the oils back onto your skin. A warm bath before you go to bed at night gives you a clean, comfortable feeling that helps you to relax and sleep well. It also helps keep your bed clean. Some people prefer to take a cool bath or shower in the morning because it makes them feel refreshed and ready for a new day. If you take a cool bath or shower, use warm water first to wash away the dirt and oil. During hot weather, you should bathe every day. If you do not take a bath every day during cold weather, you need to at least wash your hands, face, neck, ears, arms, and feet before you go to bed each night. Well, if you're going to do all of that, then many times it's just easier to hop all in, get it all taken care of at once, and hop all out, because you still need to do your hands, face, neck, ears, arms, and feet. Being clean is not only important to your health, it also affects the way you feel and the way others feel about you. And it's just an important thing. People see us, people smell us, people are around us. We want to be healthy for them just like we would want them to be healthy for us. So you've got the comprehension check on the bottom of page 67 that I want you to work on. Look at that carefully. We'll try to go over it tomorrow if I remember, hopefully. Page 68, just the very top. Think about it. See the dust. Rub the bottom of a clear glass or jar with cooking oil. So check with your parents. Set the glass or jar upside down on the top of a counter and leave it there for 24 hours. Then use a magnifying glass to see the amount of dust and dirt that has collected on the glass. This will help you understand how much dust and dirt collects on your skin, hair, and clothing every single day. So that's just a little experiment that you guys can do to recognize what actually happens on us every single day. All right. Hope that you enjoyed that and take care of yourself. Think about these things very carefully. All right. See you soon.